Let's see how Psalms 1 and 2 prepare us how to pray. Psalm 1. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the wicked, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of scoffers, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and on his law he meditates day and night. He is like a tree planted by streams of water that yields its fruit in its season, and its leaf does not wither. In all that he does, he prospers. The wicked are not so. They're like the chaff that the wind drives away. Therefore, the wicked will not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked will perish. Two things are prominent in Psalm 1. An action and an image. Just two things are prominent, an action and an image. What is the action? What is the verb that is most prominent in Psalm 1? Meditate. What is the image that's most prominent in Psalm 1? The tree. Through meditation, the roots are in the water and it bears fruit in whatever season, whatever circumstance it's in. We talked about meditation last week. There are actually two books recommended at the bottom of these sermon notes that would help you understand meditation. You go back to the podcast and listen to that. Meditation. Some words are like information in an envelope that's just passed from one person to another. Some words are like an arrow that's meant to penetrate and saturate deep down into the soul. God's word is like that. And to meditate on it is to really soak in it. The text here in verse 2 says that we delight in the word of God because we meditate on it, and we meditate on it because we delight in it. To meditate on something involves murmuring and mumbling and saying it back to yourself. There's almost a repetitive sound even to the Hebrew verb for what it means to meditate. But I just want to simply explain meditation by a verse from Isaiah. You don't have to turn there because I'm just taking the picture out of the verse. It's in Isaiah 31. And Isaiah takes us to the Discovery Channel or to Animal Planet to teach us about meditation. Isaiah has more poetry in it than just about any other prophet. And he's just making a little metaphor about something. And he uses this word meditate in chapter 31, I think it's verse 4. Isaiah says, like a lion growls over its kill. Like a lion growls over its prey. That's the Hebrew word. For meditate. So think about what's being said there. This is not a lion roaring because he's about to go kill something. This is, the lion has made the kill, and now, you know, if you have a cat, I feel bad for you, but if you have a cat, I saw that. She hates me now for the rest of my life. If you have a cat and it has something it likes, it's like, it makes noises while it's eating it. It just purrs. Not growls like it's gonna attack it, but just it purrs and it growls a little bit. A lion, just like that domesticated feline, the lion out in the wilderness, out in the jungle, it's already made the kill, but as the lion is just about to dip into that meat, the lion is just purring and growling to itself in anticipation of taking that in. You know, Psalm 119 says, when I meditate on your precepts, I will run in the way of your commandments. That lion is like, when I take this in, it's going to make me this much stronger. It's going to make my eyesight this much clearer. And it's going to make me a better hunter in the future. And who knows what kind of meat I'll go get once I'm strengthened by this. When we meditate on the word of God, that's what it means. To be licking our chops over it as we anticipate the spiritual muscles that we will develop when we take in the word of God. This is the action, and the image is that we'll be like a tree. Psalm 1, that's how it prepares us to move from a non-praying world to be a woman or a man of prayer.